लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट सेलेक्टिव एस्ट्रोजन रिसेप्टर मॉड्यूलेटर्स। एज द नेम इटसेल्फ इंडिकेट्स दैट दीज ड्रग्स दे एक्ट ऑन एस्ट्रोजन रिसेप्टर्स। ओके, दीज ड्रग्स दे एक्ट ऑन एस्ट्रोजन रिसेप्टर्स। बट द स्ट्रेंज बिहेवियर ऑफ दीज ड्रग्स इज ऑन सम एस्ट्रोजन रिसेप्टर्स दे एक्ट एज अगोनिस्ट, वेयर एज ऑन सम अदर एस्ट्रोजन रिसेप्टर्स दे एक्ट एज एंटागोनिस्ट। Right, in some is on some estrogen receptors they act as agonists, whereas on some other estrogen receptors they act as antagonists. This is how these selective estrogen receptor modulators act. Now let's see the examples we have. We have mainly two drugs to discuss. One is tamoxifen citrate. Tamoxifen citrate. And the second drug is Raloxifene. These are the two drugs we have under this category. In this lecture, we'll discuss about tamoxifen citrate. In the next lecture, we'll discuss about Raloxifene. Okay. Tamoxifen citrate. This drug, it has agonistic action on uterus, bone, liver, and pituitary. Right? On uterus, bone, liver, and pituitary, it has got agonistic action. That means the estrogen receptors that are present on uterus, bone, liver, pituitary, on these receptors, this tamoxifen citrate acts as agonist, whereas it acts as antagonist on breast, blood vessels, and some peripheral sites, right? So it acts as antagonist on breast, blood vessel, and some peripheral site, whereas it acts as agonist on uterus, bone, liver, pituitary, right? Now let's see the action on each of these sites. First, as I told you, there is agonistic action on mainly uterus, bone, liver, and pituitary, right? So as there is agonistic action on uterus, it leads to endometrial proliferation, right? It leads to endometrial proliferation. And as there is agonistic action on bone, it leads to increase in bone density. And these, as there is increased bone density, there is reduced incidence of bone fractures, right? Leads to reduced bone fractures, right? On liver, as there is agonistic action on liver, it leads to decreased LDL, right? And as there is agonistic action on pituitary, it leads to increase in certain hormones, like there is increase in prolactin and gonadotropin. Okay, sorry, there is decrease prolactin and gonadotropins, decrease in prolactin and gonadotropins. Clear? So and pituitary, it has lowering of prolactin and gonadotropin action. Okay, these things happen due to agonistic action. Now let's see antagonistic action. As I told you, it has got antagonistic action on breast, and one more is blood vessels, right, and some other peripheral site. So as there is antagonistic action on receptors present on breast, it leads to decreased chance of breast cancer. Hence we can use this in prophylaxis of breast cancer. And it can be used in post-mastectomy also. Post-mastectomy. Why do we use in post-mastectomy? Is to decrease relapse of breast cancer, right? Relapse of breast cancer. So in post-mastectomy, we use these drugs in order to prevent relapses. Clear? In breast cancer, we use this drug for adjuvant therapy and also for palliative therapy. We use for adjuvant as well as palliative therapy. When do we use palliative therapy? When the breast cancer is in advanced stages, right? In advanced stages of breast cancer, we use this drug in palliative therapy. In advanced, if the adjuvant therapy is given to premenopausal women, then this drug should be used for 5 years. For 5 years. Whereas in postmenopausal women, we use only for 2 years. After these 2 years, we'll use aromatic inhibitors. Aromatase inhibitors. Right? So we use aromatase inhibitors. And you see this, and one more important thing that we have to know here is, this is the only drug that has been approved for use in both metastatic and primary breast cancer. So this drug can be used for both primary as well as for metastatic breast cancer. Okay. This is its use in breast cancer. So whenever you are asked about tamoxifen citrate, then you have to say about breast cancer. It's used in breast cancer, right? It's mainly used for breast cancer. So let's revise the points that we have discussed. So mainly we'll see breast cancer, right? So it's mainly used in prophylaxis of breast cancer, right? Prophylaxis of breast cancer. It can be used in post-mastectomy also to decrease relapses, right? And it can be used as adjuvant therapy as well as palliative therapy. In adjuvant therapy, if the adjuvant therapy is given to premenopausal women, then it's used for only 5 years. Whereas in postmenopausal women, it is used only for 2 years. Then aromatase inhibitors are used. This is the only drug approved for. This is the first drug approved for both primary and metastatic breast cancer, right? This is the uses of amoxicillin citrate. Now let's see pharmacokinetics and side effects. Pharmacokinetics. This drug, it has biphasic plasma life, biphasic plasma half life. It has two half life, 10 hours and 7 days. These are the two half lives of tamoxifen citrate. And this is metabolized mainly in liver, right? Let's move the page up. This drug is excreted in bile. Right? Is excreted in bile. So its metabolism takes place in liver. So this is about pharmacokinetics. Now let's see the side effects. The side effects are heart flushes, vomiting, vaginal discharge. Menstrual irregularities, menstrual irregularities, and increased risk of venous thromboembolism. Okay. There are certain other side effects like dermatitis, anorexia, mild leukopenia. Okay, these are some of the side effects. Thank you for watching.